And being as we rebuilt the master cylinder, most of the air in the system is at the top, so we're actually going to push the fluid from the caliper and back up into the master cylinder, and that'll actually help us get rid of the air bubbles a lot faster than just working with the master cylinder itself. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this syringe with my dot 5. Alright, now that we have the syringe on the bleeder valve, we're going to take our 3/8 wrench and we're just going to break the bleeder valve open just enough so we can push the fluid through. You want to go slow here. As you can see, as I've been pushing slowly, you can see all the air coming up through the system. And you'll just want to keep doing that until there are no air bubbles coming up through the master cylinder hole anymore. Alright, now that we've pushed all the fluid up into the master cylinder, we are going to work with the lever itself to get the rest of the air out of the top of the line. And all we'll do for that is just play with the lever a little bit, just kind of give it some quick pumps, and I like to give it a good pump and then release, and it just kind of breaks loose those air bubbles. And every now and then, just tapping on the banjo bolt itself breaks those air bubbles loose from that joint right there. But as you can see, all the air is out of the top of the line. So at this point, I'll go to the other side and go down to the caliper. And what you'll do is you'll just give it about three to five good pumps, and then you'll hold it as tight as you can, and then pop that bleeder valve on the caliper, and it'll push the rest of that air out of the bottom of the system. Being as I'm on the left front side of the bike, I'm not able to pump the lever myself and break the bleeder valve. So if you just have a friend on the other side on the lever pumping it and holding it for you, then you can come down here. And what he'll do is just pump it a few times and hold it. And then once he's there, just break it loose. As you can see, there wasn't a whole lot of air in there because the system actually bled out really well. And once I got that tight, he can release the lever, and now your system is bled. Now that we're done bleeding the system, we can go up to the master cylinder and install the cover. And with this cover, once you get the screws down there, you'll just want to tighten them up enough just that you start to feel the seal bulge out a little bit. And you're good to go.